When you require the use of a pole for ornamental street lighting, power distribution and transmission, or for sports lighting, StressCrete poles are an excellent choice. Made from centrifugally spun concrete, they're exceptionally durable and can be installed easily and quickly for greater cost efficiency. Contractors familiar with our poles agree that ease of installation is one of the major benefits in choosing StressCrete spun concrete poles. There are three basic methods of installation. Direct embedment, which is by far the most common and cost-effective method. Base plate mounting, for installations in which direct burial is impractical, such as on bridges or parking decks. And socket mounting, which saves the cost of anchor bolts and a base plate in situations that require special footings. Unlike many other pole materials, spun concrete does not deteriorate below grade, and consequently over 90% of StressCrete concrete poles are installed using the inexpensive direct embedment method. Lighting poles such as those used in parking lots, subdivisions, and city streets are usually anywhere from 10 to 50 feet above grade and are easily installed in 30 minutes or less. The key to trouble-free installation is the selection of the right equipment, after which the process should proceed swiftly and smoothly. Let's take a step-by-step look at a typical direct embedment installation to show you what is essentially a very simple operation. After the desired pole location has been established, auger the setting hole. The hole's diameter should be 8 to 10 inches wider than the diameter of the pole butt. As for the depth, in good soil, a rule of thumb is to bury 10% of the pole length plus 2 feet. Where soil conditions are in doubt or when the pole is heavily loaded, it's recommended that a soil and structural engineer be consulted. Once the desired width and depth has been augured, an inch or so of gravel should be placed at the bottom of the hole for leveling purposes and to provide a firm footing. At this time, the pole can be pre-wired. When working with a larger crew, the augering and pre-wiring can be done simultaneously to save time. Using the fish wire provided, run the power cables through and install arms, luminaires, or brackets while the pole is still resting on the ground. Now the pole is ready to be installed. Using a nylon sling, choke the pole 20 to 25% of its length down from the tip and attach the lifting hook to the sling loop. Lift the pole smoothly to near vertical, allowing the butt to rest on the ground. Then lift the pole until the butt just clears the ground and position it over the hole. Lower the pole into the hole smoothly until the butt rests centered at the bottom of the hole. As the pole is lowered, the power cable should be guided through the aperture. Maneuver the pole until it's vertical, aligning it to 90 degrees. Then add backfill, tamping every 4 inches. Once the pole has been backfilled about 2 feet, the final alignment should be carried out. Although either a plumb bob or a transit level can be used, experienced installers usually align the pole by eye or vertical level adjusted for pole taper. Once it's in final position, backfill the pole to about 2 inches above grade, tamping thoroughly every 4 to 6 inches. Remove the sling and your crew can then move on to the next pole. For direct burial of taller poles, such as those used in power distribution and transmission, the same basic installation techniques are used. The equipment may be heavier and the installation may take slightly longer, but the actual process is the same. Even in tight downtown locations where overhead wires and lack of space can pose problems, StressCrete concrete poles are installed easily and quickly. The proper lighting of sports facilities may well demand the use of poles with an overall length in excess of 100 feet. The weight of these poles can exceed 20,000 pounds, so selection of the right equipment is critical. Poles are usually dressed on the ground before being lifted into position. And while the basic technique is similar to other pole installation, it must be remembered that the equipment installed at the top of the pole can weigh up to 4,000 pounds. When lifting, the sling must be moved up the pole to compensate. As with the distribution poles we just looked at, tamping the backfill every 4 inches is essential. When StressCrete's Americana poles are installed, tamping is carried out in the normal way until the flared base intrudes. At this point, vertical tamping is no longer practical, and backfill is consolidated by tamping against the pole's burial section till completed. Because of the ornamental flared base on Americana poles, it becomes essential that the hole is augered to the correct depth to ensure the appearance of the pole is not compromised. The depth of the hole can be adjusted by using more or less gravel in the bottom. If the pole is set in an area that will be paved, ensure that it's a couple of inches higher than grade to accommodate the height of the paving material. While spun concrete poles are tough and durable in service, they should be handled with some care. Although shorter poles may be unloaded using a single pickup at the point of balance, for safety reasons, a two-point pickup is recommended for all poles and specifically required for poles over 50 feet in length, with the two points positioned approximately 20% of the pole length apart. When stored, poles should be supported so that they do not bend under their own weight. To ensure hassle-free erection of StressCrete spun concrete poles, here are a few useful tips to keep in mind. Use a 2x4 to align the pole while the weight is still held by the crane. Simply insert a 2x4 in the below-grade wiring aperture and push or pull to turn the pole in the right direction. To reclaim the sling after installation is complete, attach a rope to it before erecting the pole so it can be retrieved from the ground. To ensure easy electrical connections, make sure that the cables are long enough to be worked on outside the pole rather than inside the raceway. Once wiring is complete, stuff the wires back into the handhole. Always lift the pole smoothly. A severe shock could fracture it. In urban situations where poles may be installed on a sidewalk or plaza, it's recommended that the pole is surrounded by paving brick or grass rather than concrete to ensure ease of replacement in case of damage. When concrete backfill is specified, a tripod can be used to hold the pole in place while the concrete sets. This will free up the crane and enable the crew to move on to the next pole more quickly. Whatever the appropriate method of installation, be it direct embedment, base plate, or socket mount, StressCrete concrete poles go up quickly. As always, time is money, and the ease of our installation means your crew can work faster and more productively to get the job done on time and on budget. StressCrete spun concrete poles. Cost-effective, durable, easy to install. The solid choice for your next project.